Welcome back to the second video. In this video, we'll talk about basic diet tips and a basic diet guide. Diet is a really big part of diabetes management, so hopefully the next few tips can help you get started, maybe give you a few ideas too on where to improve. It's important not to change everything all at once when you're trying to make some diet changes. It's a lot easier to set one or two little small goals than trying to change everything in your diet all at once. It'll be a lot easier to kind of hopefully stick to those changes. We'll start at the first. Portion is a really big part of diabetes management too. An easy way to look at it, there's in some of your little documents, there's going to be one with a plate on it. So that's the healthy plate. It looks, it makes it easier to kind of visualize what you're eating and what is on your plate. If you look at it, about half of that plate is going to be vegetables. So if you can aim for half of your plate in vegetables, that's a really good start. Most of the vegetables don't raise your blood sugars, and they do contain a lot of nutrients without adding too many calories, and they help to fill you up at the same part. And then you'll see on the plate too, about a quarter of the plate is with starches and grains. So those would be your things like potatoes, it could be rice, it could be pasta. But going for a quarter of your plate is going to help help to manage your blood sugars with that. And then the last quarter is foods that are high in protein. So that could be your meat. If you eat meat, it could be fish. Some people will eat eggs or beans, lentils, chickpeas, some of those. So if a quarter of your plate can be protein food as well, then you're doing really well with that plate. It's also important to get regular meals. So if you're eating at least three meals a day, and not like spacing them out, not eating, not going long times without eating. So if you can eat at least every 6 hours, it is helpful to manage your blood sugars. It's gonna help your body kind of manage your blood sugars as well. Some people will eat snacks in between. If you do feel hungry, it could be a good thing to go for. So if you're going for snacks in between meals, if you're feeling hungry. But at least eating three meals a day is gonna be key to help your body kind of adjust to the blood sugars and help your body manage those blood sugars. And like we said, with a healthy plate, it makes it a little bit easier and a little bit easier to visualize what your plate should look like. And even if your plate doesn't look like that right now, that might be the goal in the future. So even starting with a few changes, if you're not eating any vegetables on your plate, even starting out with like a quarter of your plate in vegetables, that's a really good start. And then slowly increasing with that till you reach about half of your plate in vegetables. If you do snack, it could be a good idea to snack on things like fruits or vegetables. They are really low in calorie and they do kind of fill you up at the same time. Some people will snack on things that have protein in them as well. So it could be like a handful of nuts with a piece of fruit. Crackers and cheese can be a good idea for a snack as well. But don't feel the need to snack if you don't feel hungry in between your meals. It's not necessary to add a snack between each meals. It's a good idea if you're trying to manage your blood sugars to limit the times that you're eating sugary things or drinking sugary things like juice or pop, eating sweets, which are like cake and cookies. If you do eat them often, they do add a lot of calories and they do raise your blood sugars fairly easily too, especially if you're looking into things like pop or juice, anything that's really sugary and liquid. Your body doesn't need to do a whole lot to digest it, so most of that sugar is going to go really quickly in your blood, and it might be tough for your body to adjust to that big change in blood sugars too. So it's a good idea to limit. I mean, it doesn't mean that you'll never eat things like cake or that you should never eat cookies or drinking a glass of juice, but if you can limit them, and on special occasions, if it's your birthday and you're having a piece of cake, it makes it a little bit more special too if you're kind of limiting those times. One good idea as well is to increase your fiber intake, and we will talk a little bit more about fiber in the next few videos, but fiber, what it does, it helps to kind of keep you full, and you'll find fiber in whole grains. There's going to be high in fiber. Fruits, vegetables will have some fiber in them too. And then you'll find fiber in things like beans and nuts. But basically what fiber does, it helps to fill you up without raising your blood sugars. So if you are eating foods that have a little bit more fiber in them, it is helpful to manage your blood sugars and avoid big spikes in blood sugars as well. Making water your drinking choice is a good idea too. It doesn't raise your blood sugars. There's no calories, but it does keep you hydrated too. So if for the most part, you can kind of choose to drink water and drink water more often, instead of going for things that have more sugar in them. So like regular pop or regular juices. Some people might find, especially if they're used to drinking pop, going for something like a diet pop might be a good option just because it doesn't raise your blood sugars. They use sugar substitute in them. So it's a good idea if you are drinking some pop and you want to switch to something else to help out your blood sugars, drinking diet pop can be an option. But making water your drinking choice and making sure you're getting enough water too. And it might be helpful to drink water in between your meals or with your meals, depending on how much water you need in the day and if you feel thirsty, definitely go for a drink of water. So all those quick tips can help you manage your diabetes. Obviously, it's not individualized, so it's not necessarily something that everybody is going to find helpful, but it's just some basic quick tips to hopefully give you a few ideas and maybe set you in the right direction. But like I said at the start, if you can pick one or two small changes to make, and then once you're used to those changes and they are in your routine, maybe looking towards different changes after. It's going to be a lot easier to stick to those changes than trying to change 10 different things all at once and making it a little harder for you to stick to those if you're picking a bunch of different changes instead of going for one or two.